Hello everyone and welcome to my second tutorial of Eve. This is gonna be my production tutorial. So, basic production is building like everything that's in the game except for a few things that are still being supplied by NPCs, but then not many. Well, everything that's on the market in Eve can be produced by players. So, let's get starting with this. First things first, you need some skills. Depending a bit on what you're gonna do is, what you're planning to do is, are you gonna buy the minerals off market? If so, then look at my other tutorial that's about station trading and look at there are skills that you need to basically buy the minerals off market for less, little bit of a less price, or at least less on taxes. If you're just starting very new, you don't have the money for it to do production or buy at least the minerals off the market, then it's a very good way to just start mining yourself and mine all the minerals together and get started like that. And the only thing then you need to buy off market is Megasite and Zynroid, because you cannot get it in high second unless you are incredibly lucky, but don't count on it. There's now then those belts in low sec, but that's a risk of going out there, of course. So you need minerals. Well, of course, there are a lot of minerals you need. Basic material mineral is titanium. Ferrite. Then we have another maxilon, isogen, noxium, zynroid and megasite. These are all the minerals you need to do production. Now I think there's another one in here, morphite. Well, this is not about the Tech 1 production, that's for Tech 2 production, more the advanced production. That's for another tutorial. So that are minerals you need. But a little bit depending on what you build is different on amount of minerals, because some things don't need it. But before you start building, you need some skills again. Yes, it's skills again in Eve. As usual. So you always stand a few production slots. It's not an issue. The main skill you really need before you start producing is production efficiency. Production efficiency is decreasing 5% of material requirements needs for the production. So really, before you do, at least get this to 4 and as quick as possible to 5, because you're really gonna save a lot of it. Now, how you can see that? Well, unfortunately I have it at 5, so I cannot see it. You go to the show info on an item, then go build of materials, then you see a materials list. If you don't have this skill at 5, it's gonna be another line here that says you, and then the amount of materials that you gonna do. Well, this one is perfect. That will show up then. So production efficiency, really very important to get this one. Then you have mass production. Basically, this gives you one additional slot to run another manufacturing job. I don't know what's the basic amount you have, but this gives you so another 5 production slots. And you have advanced mass production, gives you another additional run on manufacturing jobs. So yeah, okay. It's when you start, you have one production slot. Because these two skills together give you 10 additional slots production slots and you have a maximum of 11 production slots you can have. So that's another, that's a very good skill if you're really gonna go big in production. Then there's not another skill, industrial. This is gonna give you 4% reduction in manufacturing time per level. So make it basically production time gets shorter. That's it. And then we have another skill, supply chain management. Not really too important, but really handy if you travel around a lot, want to start jobs. Simply per level is changing the distance that you can start jobs remotely. That's it all. That's all of that one. So that are really the skills you need for production. Then of course you need a BPO. Now I think, what is a BPO? BPO is a blueprint original. So that's basically it, a BPO. But of course there are also BPCs. So there's a blueprint copy. A copy has a limited amount of runs on it, depending on what the other player has set for when it made a copy. An original has unlimited amount of runs. It's, you can do as much as you can. Like a frigate has, says a normal BPC can have maximum 30 runs. But on a BPO you can do like 60 straight away, double if you want. So now where do you get those BPOs? Well, BPOs, simple, they're on the market. Doesn't matter what you're looking for, they're all on the market. But there's a little bit of a tricky thing here. If you look at the ships here, now these are battleships. We're in the Amar space, so they're on the market here. Clan ships, these are put on by players, because if you want one of those you need to go to the clan space. Same for Mimitar and Kaldari. So not everything is seeded everywhere in EVE. So, and in the OSEC there's nothing seeded, that's all player driven. So there you get your BPOs. Then of course, when you have a BPO, it's still expensive to produce something. I can show it like this. This is a gamma medium, this one is unresearched. This is the mounted use. Oh, this is really a bad one. I got a calcal here. Let's pick up the original one. Cruisers. I'm not sure if it's seeded. It is seeded, but it doesn't matter. So we're gonna look at the materials. I'll make this one a little bit bigger. There we go. Now, basically, this one is standard. I'm gonna open this one with it. There we go. Now you see two of the same one. Now, if you look very careful, you see there is a difference on the amount of minerals you need to produce. Gonna skip this one, the extra materials, because there's no change on this. Now, how do you get this? Simply, you need to research it. You can do that in every high sec, not in every station, but you can. Now, you have here, you see a material level and a production level. Material level, when you buy a BPO off market, there's zero, and same for the production. Now, if you research it in a station, there are research slots you can find. You go simply go to science and industry installations, and then you can hear for material research and set a current region and to public. You see that they're all everywhere, there are slots where you can do research. We see most of them are completely filled up always, and you're gonna have a terrible waiting time. Well, I'm lucky, I don't have to do a deal with this, because I have the access to a boss where I can do research. But if you get these levels up, material level up, like mine is at 36, it's gonna use less materials to build a ship. Way less. And that saves you money again and make more profit. Now there's this other one, the production level. If you get this one up, I have it only at 10, it's gonna save you on production time. So how high the production level, how faster you can produce it. That's it. That's all what you want. Now there's also a short name for material level and production level. You got ME material level, and PE is production level. That's just a short term for it. Now, this, now you can start producing. Now you also saw there was an extra material for it, for this. This is recently implanted, not for all ships. But if you calculate out how much it's gonna cost for a ship to build, and you have an extra material in it, you must calculate this materials with it too. But this one is not gonna be affected by the material level, not at all. This is always the same material, it cannot be changed. So you need to get that into. Now then it's simply starting from right click and say manufacturing. Then you need to pick a slot where you want it. Usually I say current blueprint location. There you can select a slot. You see this one is incredibly full here. But I don't need to produce it. So you select a slot somewhere. I just click this one and then you set the amount you want to build, like 10. And you select OK and your job starts. Now, these ones say, let's go here. For one run, you produce one cargo. Now, crystals for the MR lasers, one run produces one. Now, there's a difference for missiles. It's for missiles, projectile ammo, and hybrid ammo. There's a little bit of a difference in production. Basically, from this, oh, it's a big screen. If you start a job of this one, let's say you do one run, you get 100 missiles out of one run. The max amount of runs of this is 1500 runs. If you do 1500 runs, you get 150,000 missiles. In this case, Infernal Heavy missiles. This is how this ammo production works. Only it's not for the crystals, for the MR lasers. That's not the case. There's one run, it's just one of them. That's it for it. Now, if you want to do start production and you don't have the money for it to start big off and do big things, it's a very smart idea. This is a tip for everyone: start production, start building ammunition. Look a bit on the market, what's the price for ammunition, and figure out what's the cost for you to build it, and build that. Really, ammunition is a pretty good way to start. Because you don't need much materials and you're really gonna make a decent profit out of it. Because everyone use ammunition. If you go writing this, you use ammunition. PvP is using ammunition. Mission runners are using ammunition. They're just all using ammunition to get their money in, and there's a good money in there, definitely. So I think I covered about everything already for production. It's basically, it's not much. Get your simple, get the research, get the skills you need. Really, production efficiency is very important. You have that driving down the amount of minerals you need to build something, a ship or missiles. It's for every BPO, it's that production efficiency is working for that. So you really need it. Now you see here some faction stuff. You cannot build this. It's not possible to build this only by some kind of shop. You can get it. For next one, the tutorial is gonna be tech tool production. There's gonna be a whole different story about it. It's gonna be research in it. There's gonna be another type of production in it, and then another production. Is two types of production you need to do for that. But that's something for the next tutorial we're gonna do. This was just the basic production, what you can do. And of course production, there's another one, production. I forgot about it, I just see it here. It's rig production. You can also build rigs for ships. Basically the same story as for this, only you need salvage for this. You can also buy it off market or get it yourself for missions. And you build rigs from it. The rest of it for the rigs, everything is the same. Material level, the ME level, that's it. And PE level, of production level. That's all the same with this. Except for rigs, there's no extra materials in this. It's only four sizes these days. You have small rigs, medium rigs, large rigs, and capital rigs. Basically, small rigs don't use much, and capital rigs use a hell of a lot of material for it to only build one. So that was the basics of production. Of course, if you start a job, it's gonna cost you a little bit of money. The installation cost is 1,000 isk, and it costs per hour 170. I don't think this is affected by any standing, but I'm not even 100% sure about that. I think it does, but not quite sure about it. What? That was the basic of production. If you have any questions, you can always leave it down in the comments, or maybe I've missed something, but I don't think so. And yeah, we'll see you guys in the next tutorial about the tech tool production. We're gonna cover that, and that's gonna be a whole of a different story. So see you guys hopefully in the next tutorial, and fly safe.